So each month we take a look at our year-long herbicides program trial, and that's something we're going to focus in on today. So here, this is non-treated control plot. We've got a whole kind of mixed bag of plants here. We've got our desirable turf and our Bermuda grass that's here. We've got Virginia buttonweed, which is a perennial broadleaf weed that we see here that's a little bit more yellowish green and kind of shiny on the leaves. Interesting thing about Virginia buttonweed, has both above and below ground flowers. It's really hard to control, particularly with single applications. We've got crabgrass in this plot here. So this is smooth crabgrass that's going to be intermixed within this plot. We've got Dallas grass in this plot. So this clump-like plant here, this is another perennial grassy weed that's really hard to control. We've got some clover that's in this plot here. That's another perennial broadleaf weed. And then kind of mixed throughout, it might be hard to see because it has a grass-like appearance. We've got Kalinga in this plot. So that's another problematic perennial weed in our climate that's really hard to control, and a reason why we need herbicide programs to try to target so many different weeds within our desirable turf. So this is a program from HARRELL'S. You know, one of the ideas behind this program is how do we come in and look at timely herbicide applications coupled with timely fertilizer applications. And we can see really clean turf here. You know, this has had a spring post-emergence cleanup, some pre-emergence chemistry in the spring, particularly an echelon application that's done a really good job of taking the Kalinga out of this stand, and then other herbicide treatments throughout the year, as you can see. And right now we've got almost weed-free turf with really high turf quality. This is another program from HARRELL'S as well, again kind of coupling that fertilizer plus herbicide concept together. This has had some more recent treatments. You can see in the center of the plot some symptomology on some broadleaf weeds, some from some more recent applications there, but all in all we've reduced our overall weed pressure. Our quality of our turf might be a little bit behind what we saw previously, in large part because weed control earlier in the season was higher with the first program. And this is another program from HARRELL'S here at the end. Kind of the same story. We've done a really good job reducing our weed pressure. You can see kind of outside of the plot in the back half there, almost a straight line where we have treated in the front, non-treated outside, and really good overall control, particularly of Virginia buttonweed and crabgrass. So this is a program from REGAL. Again, this is looking at fertility and herbicide kind of put together. So this would have had an application of Regal Star on fertilizer in the spring, some post-emergence cleanups in spring as well, summer application of Echelon, and this will get treatments with residual chemistry in the fall. But here, as we shoot this today, pretty good job reducing overall weed pressure here, particularly our crabgrass and Virginia buttonweed, as well as our Kalinga, and high turf quality. This is another program from REGAL here. Only difference between what you saw from our first REGAL program and this one was our summer residual program is a little bit different. Here we have REGAL Cade 50 instead of our Echelon, and we notice that there's a difference here in terms of we've got some more Virginia buttonweed in these plots, maybe a little bit more Kalinga in these plots. We saw a real difference there between changing that mid-season component. So this is a program from Syngenta with all Syngenta chemistry in it. So this had Barricade plus Monument in the spring. This is a nice mixture treatment to control winter annual weeds and then get a pre-down for summer annual weed management. We've got applications of Pennant and Monument going out in late spring throughout the summer, and then this will have a Monument Princep treatment in the fall for POA control, and we're going to talk a lot about POA control in other videos, but that is something that we're really big believers in, is mixtures for weed management. We can see our turf quality here is really good, done a nice job controlling weeds. So this is another Syngenta program. We're kind of altering the summer component here, and we're incorporating manuscript in mixtures with monument instead of pennant in mixtures with monument. Manuscript is a new product from Syngenta, an ACCase inhibitor for post-emergence grass control, particularly crabgrass. There's some activity on signal grass, as well as some other perennial grassy weeds. Overall, we can see here our weed control efficacy is excellent. So this is a program for PBI Gordon, looking at a spring application of barricade, kind of setting the table, if you will, to control our summer annuals. Coming in with Speed Zone and Katana to control any remaining broadleaf weeds, little early activity on sedges. This had a Q4 application 2 weeks ago for summer broadleaf weed control, as well as a little bit of crabgrass control as well. And we can see our overall turf quality here is excellent. This is another program from PBI. We're kind of changing a little bit of the components. So the first one had a barricade application in spring. Here we have a spectacle application in spring. Spectacle is a different mode of action from barricade. So that rotation can be important. And this had Q4 plus as well as switchblade in late spring and early summer. Switchblade is a herbicide being developed by PBI Gordon for post-emergence broadleaf weed control. And then this will have a Katana barricade mixture in the fall for POA. Again, another mixture concept for POA, which is something that is becoming increasingly important. As we see today, our overall weed control efficacy of this program is excellent. Our turf quality is really high. So this is another PBI program, continuing with spectacle in the springtime. Instead of our Q4 switchblade Katana regime in the summer, this is incorporating PBI's new sedge control product, which is Vexus. That's an ALS inhibitor. It is sold as a granular herbicide. This had an application of Vexus in May, another application of Vexus in July, and it recently had an application of Q4 plus, and you might notice that there's a little bit of a yellowing on our Bermuda grass here from that Q4 plus application that was applied only a few days ago. So here we've got another program from PBI Gordon. This is barricade in the spring, and that's all that this had was an application of barricade applied in March. That's going to be really active on summer annual grasses, but as one can imagine, that's going to miss some of our broadleaf weeds, and we had a really high broadleaf weed pressure situation in this plot. We came in July with an application of Speed Zone and Pilex. You know, that's a treatment that has gained a lot of traction for goosegrass control because of the activity of both of those actives. But one of the things about that mixture is Speed Zone is a very broad spectrum broadleaf treatment. And you can see we have really reduced the overall broadleaf weed pressure in this plot. Our Bermuda grass in the center is largely unaffected. We've got some remaining broadleaf plants left, but overall broadleaf weed pressure has gone down. As you can see, we have non-treated strips at the back half of each plot, and if you kind of keep your eye along that strip, you can see broadleaf weed pressure. We also have some Kalinga pressure in there as well. So this is another program from PBI, a spring application of barricade, and then we come back in late spring with switchblade and Katana, and then in the summer we made an application of Surge, another PBI Gordon product for broadleaf weed control. And you can see by looking at this plot, our turf quality is really high. We've done a really good job reducing our overall weed pressure here. So this is a BASF program. This is a program that's right off the label for tower. It's kind of structured for dove weed control. We don't have dove weed in this site, but obviously if we have a program that's going to have activity on dove weed, that's going to touch a lot of other weed species as well. So this had two spring applications of Pendulum to kind of target our summer annual weeds with residual chemistry, and two summer applications of Surge, and then this will get freehand later on in the year for POA control. That's a treatment that we've done a lot of work with over the past few years that's gained a little bit of traction amongst the superintendent community for POA management. This is another BASF program here. So this is just one application at a higher rate of Pendulum in the spring. We're coming in then with a drive application in June to clean up any crabgrass that may have broken through that early season treatment. And it's had nothing since then. And we are going to try a new concept here in the fall for POA management. We're going to put tower and pendulum together, both liquid formulations. The freehand that we've has been used in the industry for a few years is formulated as a granule. That's really hard to apply over large acreage. We think that the mixture could give us similar results, so we're going to test that in the fall of 2020. This is a program from FMC. So this had a March application of Echelon, a June application of Solitaire, and then a blindside application in July. All of those are going to target our sedges, our Kalingas. The Solitaire and blindside in particular, you're going to touch on broadleaf weeds because blindside contains metsulfuron. Solitaire is going to help us on the grass front because it contains quinclorac. And then this will have a Katana exonerate mixture for POA management in the fall. This is a program from Corteva. This had a Roundup application during dormancy, which is very common across Tennessee to clean up a whole suite of winter annual weeds pretty effectively. An application of Crew in the springtime, which is a product that many may be unfamiliar with. This is a mixture of isoxaben, which is the active ingredient in gallery, which has been used in ornamentals for a long time, combined with thiopure, the active ingredient in dimension. So the concept is, let's get control of some of our broadleaf weeds and our grassy weeds with one treatment. It had a sequential application of dimension. It's had an application of Game On as well in June, and another application of Game On in August. Game On is a new broadleaf mixture from Corteva that contains the active ingredient haloxifen, and then this will have Curb and Katana in the fall. So this is a program that we put together kind of focused towards the golf industry. One of the things we've seen, particularly on golf courses, we have data now through research that was supported by the Golf Course Superintendents Association of America. We know that over 60% of the annual bluegrass in the state of Tennessee on golf courses has some level of glyphosate resistance. So the concept is, can we target annual bluegrass with different modes of action than glyphosate? One of the areas we've had success with is looking at Reward tank mixed with Princep, applied in February. That's the same time one would treat their Bermuda grass with glyphosate. Here we're putting out Reward and Princep, two different modes of action. That's helpful for cleaning up our winter annuals, particularly POA. We came back after that with an application of Barricade for our summer annual weed management pre. We put down another mode of action in late May in Ronstar and a granular carrier. And this had just very recently had a tribute total treatment. You can see some symptomology, particularly on the Virginia buttonweed plants in the center of this plot, as well as some of our Kalingas from that recent August application of tribute total. And this will have freehand in the fall. Do you have webinar fatigue? Do you feel like you've been on Zoom too long this summer? Check out Turf Talk, a new series from the University of Tennessee Turfgrass program.